dear viewers and students, this is a teacher from Morogoro. My name is Madam Chiku Gaimo. I'm teaching English in Form 4. Today, I want to proceed with topic number 3, that is about reading literary work. Today, I want to give the analysis of the novel Passed Like a Shadow. This novel has been written by Bernardi Mapalala, and the setting of this book is Western Uganda, that is East Africa. It is published by the Oxford University Press in 2006. Now, in analyzing the novel, we have to deal with two things, that is form and content. Now, I want to start with the form. When analyzing the form of the book, there are some elements that have to be touched. One is the title. When we are analyzing form, we just look at the superstructure of that work of art. The book, the novel, Passed Like a Shadow, how this book is organized, the superstructure or the layout of this book. Now, let us start with the title of the book, Passed Like a Shadow. This title is presented as symbolic in such a way that you cannot define this word, see, directly. It is there just to, the word Passed Like a Shadow has been used there to show or to relate the short life lived by the young talented generation, and Passed Like a Shadow has been used to show that these people, these talented people, important people, educated one, they have just survived for the short period of time, like that of a shadow. The shadow do exist for a short period of time, just maybe during the day where there is light. The disappearance of the light is where the shadow disappears. So it existed just for a short period of time. The life of these people in this novel has been compared with that of a shadow. Why? These people existed only for a short period of time after being infected by the pandemic, HIV/AIDS pandemic. They have been infected by HIV disease. Another element of form is the setting. The setting of this novel is Western Uganda. The setting is Western Uganda, particularly West Africa. And by setting here, apart from place also, we do give out the time. The time is during the end, at the end of the Idi Amin War. Tanzania and Uganda War. Is during the time of Idi Amin's rule. That is the setting of this novel. Now, when coming to this book, the setting has been divided into two parts. Mr. Bernardi Mapalala, the author of this book, has divided the setting of this book into two parts. One is the rural setting. We have witnessed the rural setting due to the presence of this witch doctor. For example, in Kahina, this issues of, witch doctor is very common in rural areas. Also, the author has been showing us sports beating. As we have witnessed, Mr. Adieri punishing his wife. This practice is very common in rural areas. Another part of setting is the urban setting. The author have employed this urban setting, and we have seen it with where the author using these urban centers, famous urban centers like Kampala, like Kachwamba, Kasese Town, and others. This shows that the author has used the urban setting. Also, the presence of restaurants is very common in town, and also this prostitution is very much practiced in, I mean, in urban areas. So this features has showed us that the author have used this type of setting. We have also other setting, like a hospital setting, where Mr. Adieri has been admitted, and also we have a school setting where Mr. Adieri has been working as the headmaster of St. Lucy High School. Dear students, when you are analyzing form, also we have to say something about plot. What is plot? When we are talking plot here, we are looking at the arrangement of events in that particular literary work. How the events have been analyzed in that work. Now, when you go to this book, to this particular novel, this book, the analysis of this book, we can say it is a flashback in such a way that the later events is presented at the beginning of the book. When you look at this book, when you start reading a book, at the first chapter, you may come across with that aggressive treatment Mr. Adieri is giving to his wife and children. At that part of the book, you might ask yourself, what is the reason behind? Why this man is doing this and this? What is the reason behind? That means this, how many events are not arranged in a sequence. It's not arranged in sequence. That's plot. Another element that you have to deal when analyzing form is characters and characterization. What is character, dear students? Dear viewers, when we are talking of characters in any literary work, here we are talking of maybe it might be a person, sometimes an animal, or anything being employed by the author to carry or to deliver the intended message. That is characters. And how these people behave, or how that particular character being used behave, is what we are referring as characterization. Now, in this part, I'm going to show you, I'm going to describe different characters. Let us now start with the main character, Mr. Adieri. This is the main character. The father of a family, the father of Abuki and Atoki, the husband of Amoti. He's the former headmaster of St. Leo's High School. He becomes hopeless, drunkard, and womanizer after losing his job. He is very irresponsible father. He fails to provide necessary needs for his family. Also, Mr. Adieri used to beat his wife, as we have witnessed in the first chapter, but he's also thrown out of his job just by having sexual relationship with his former secretary, Birungi. He was later infected by HIV. He's very greedy man. Mr. Adieri is very great, as we have seen him demanding a large amount of bride price. This man wants a man to pay a large amount of bride price. That's why I say he's very great. Adieri dies very miserable of HIV pandemic disease after suffering for a long period of time. The main character, Mr. Adieri. Let's go and have a look to another main character, his wife, Amoti. Amoti is a wife of Mr. Adieri and a mother of two children, Toki and Abuki. She is playing a role of a caring mother to her children, as she's seen protecting them when his father was beating them several times. Atoki is a jealous woman, as we have seen him, because she used to hate Birungi, a woman who shared the love with her husband. She is revengeful, as we have seen him when Abdieri was sick. Amoti refused to take care of Adieri just for the bad treatment Mr. Adieri used to do during his days. The woman is very revengeful. Amoti also dies of HIV pandemic just after being infected by her husband, Mr. Adieri. This is the second character. Another character, dear students, is Atoki. Who is Atoki? The son of Mr. Adieri. The firstborn and the son of Mr. Adieri and Amoti. He suffers from poor upbringing by his father. As we have been told, Mr. Adieri was not a responsible father. Therefore, the effect was seen to this son. Also, he later became a famous footballer nicknamed Fort Porto Bullet by the time he is in high school. Atoki builds a house for his mother and sister after being separated from his father. He managed to build a house just after the completion of his education. He built the house and he was providing some necessary needs to his family, to his mother and his sister Abuki. Later on, Atoki falls in love with a woman, a public relations officer, Eda, in Kampala. As a result, he becomes a victim of HIV disease. Another character is from this family of Mr. Adieri. It's Abuki. Abuki is the Adieri's and Amoti's daughter. She is the sister of Atoki. Abuki is a decent and disciplined girl, as we have seen him. She takes care of her sick mother, father, and later her brother Atoki. Later, Abuki was raped by the hypocrite Johnny, who breaks her virginity at her young age. Johnny employed a trick which made Abuki to break her virginity. She is also sympathetic and forgiving person. As this has been seen, how she takes care of her brother Atoki, despite his past mistakes he did at her and to her mother. Another character, my dear students, is Vicky. Who is Vicky? Vicky is Adieri's the daughter of Adieri's late sister. He's Adieri's niece and the cousin of Abuki and Atoki. She's also a victim of poor upbringing, as this has been seen from the results of the mistreatment from her uncle and his wife Amoti. She was not given proper treatment. That's why she later engaged in prostitution. Vicky resorts to sell her body just for the purpose of fulfilling her needs, nobody caring about her. Vicky was later chased away from home, from Adieri's house, just because she was seen riding a bicycle. Mr. Adieri sent Vicky into exile just because riding a bicycle for the girl, it is against African culture, particularly Ugandan culture. She was chased away. Later on, Vicky was affected by the peer pressure her friends to see him, and Kunihira convinced Vicky to keep her love for sale. She engages in prostitution. Vicky later on, this girl becomes a wife of Alganira. But also Vicky and Ganira, they later being infected by this pandemic, they got from the witch doctor. It's where Vicky fails to get a baby. Her husband Alganira sent Vicky to the witch doctor. She was later infected by HIV or AIDS. Another character, my dear viewers, is Birungi. Who is Birungi? Birungi is a woman. She was a concubine of Adieri, who lives at Burungu. She's a prostitute and a cruel exploiter of men. She chases Adieri away with the police when he needed her. At that time, Mr. Adieri was sick. But when he was there from the hospital, this Birungi chased Adieri away. Also, Birungi is Adieri's former secretary. She was a former secretary where Adieri was working as the headmaster at St. Leo's High School. At that time, Mr. Adieri, as the headmaster, Birungi was his secretary. She's ignorant with the disease called SLIM. That's why she chased Mr. Adieri, just because she was afraid to be infected by that particular disease. She has no knowledge about HIV AIDS. David. Who is David, my dear students? David is a friend of Atoki. He's the son of an important man and a rich man in Kampala. His father was an important person in the government. He is Atoki's best friend and a university reject or dropout. He fails to complete his university education. He is a womanizer who influences Atoki to start hunting for women. David becomes a HIV victim and spread it intentionally to unaffected girls. That's the behavior of this boy. He's also a victim of poor upbringing by his father, who used it to give freedom, as much freedom, to have a casual sexual relationship. He was affected by poor upbringing, just like Atoki. His father died of AIDS, pandemic disease, and left his mother in the bed suffering from the same disease. This is David. Another character who have been used by this author is Ada. Dear viewers, Ada is a woman, is a government employee, working as a public relations officer. She's a prostitute who hunts for men in town. Apart from being employed, she also dealing with prostitution. She is cheap and an easygoing girl as she convinces Atoki to make love with her. This is Ada. Another character who has been used in this book is Johnny. Who is Johnny, my dear viewers? Johnny is a boy from a rich family. He is a hypocrite as seen by the way he tricks Abuki and he breaks her virginity after putting drugs in her drink. That's the behavior of Johnny. He is a misleading and exploitative who misuses Abuki for his pleasure. Alianira is a character who is Vicky's husband. He is a rich man who takes Vicky to a witch doctor so that she can get a baby. It's where Vicky was infected by HIV pandemic. She is superstitious, yes, because he believes in charms and the power of witch doctor. Other characters, that is the friends of Vicky, Tusime and Kunihira. Vicky's female friends. They sell their bodies, they engage in prostitution, they sell their bodies and exploit men. They convince Vicky, they use the energy to convince Vicky to engage in that business of selling her body. They are ignorant of this disease, which is nicknamed the Slim. They don't have even a little knowledge concerning this HIV disease. Other character is Uncle Arali. Who is Uncle Arali, my dear students? He is a brother of Mr. Arali, who lives at Ihunga village in Kitagwenda. He supports the family of his brother, as we have seen him several times, paying school fees, giving some necessary needs to this family, that is Uncle Arali. He is a kind and loving man. He's so kind and loving man. He welcomes Atoki, invites Atoki and Abuki when their parents died. This is Uncle Arali. Apart from that, we have been dealing with an element of form, that is characters and characterization. The people which have been used by this author and how they behave is what we call characters and characterization. Let's go to another element of form. The organization of this week, another element that you are going to deal is the style. What is the style? The novel is very rich. This novel is very rich in style. The author has employed different styles. One is a point of view. When you read this novel, the writer has used the three persons. However, the third person is the dominant one. This is to say that the author is the one who narrates the story. He is giving us the story. He is speaking on behalf of these characters. He mostly used the third person just to deliver the message. He is giving us the story. That is the point of view. Another part of style is the use of dialogue among characters. Here, characters have been exchanging conversation. One is speaking after another. As you can see, this is where there was a conversation between Adeli and Amoti when Vicky comes back from Kitagwenda with Akena, a man who wants to marry Vicky. Amoti is talking to Mr. Adiel. He's saying that, I have told you that Vicky has come with a visitor. Adiel said that, a visitor? Amoti said, yes, a visitor. Adiel, is the visitor tall or short? Mr. Adiel asked me. So this is an example of how dialogue have been used in this particular novel. That is the use of dialogue, conversation between characters. Another element of the style is the use of monologue. What is monologue, dear viewers? It's where it's the situation where a character who is alone speaks his thoughts. He speaks his thoughts aloud. The person is speaking alone. The way he thinks, he tries to give out aloud. Adele, in page 15, you can see Adele saying that this visitor has really caught us when we are dead broke. Adele is speaking on himself. This visitor has really caught us when we are dead broke. He lamented, Adele lamented to himself, what a pet. I wish I was a rich man or a millionaire. This way, Adele was speaking alone. We call this monologue. The author has used the monologue. So when a person is speaking alone, the way he thinks, he decided to put it aloud, it comes out automatically. Apart from monologue, dear viewers, also in this book, the author has used the songs. This can be seen in page 15 of this book. Adele sings when he drank. God bless Uganda, oh, forward Uganda, forward bravery, hardest peace. That is an example of a song being sung by Mr. Adele. So in describing the form, we can say that the author had used the song from this book in page 15. Also, in the part of style, the author has used a flashback kind of style. How this style looks like? As I have told you when I was describing plot, the author used the flashback kind of style in such a way that the later events comes, it is presented at the beginning of the novel. When you read that novel, in page one, in chapter one, you can come out to the, you can see Mr. Adele, the main character, beating his wife. He's giving aggressive treatment to his family. At that part, we don't know the reason behind, but from chapter number five, we can see, the author giving out the background of this man. He said that he was a former headmaster, he was a former teacher at different schools. He's giving out the background of this man. So coming, reading about when you see this aggressive treatment, you might ask yourself, why this happens? Who is this man? But later on, the author come to give out, come to describe this man. So that kind of style, you can say, is a flashback. The events are not arranged in sequence, are not arranged in a chronological order. That is the style which has been used by this author in that particular book. Also, my dear students, in analyzing form, we have to say something concerning the language. How the language has been used, what kind of the language has been used in this book. By referring past like a shadow, the language used is very simple, straightforward, and easy to understand. Moreover, the novelist has employed many idioms, sayings, and different literary devices in order in his attempt to deliver the intended messages. Now, these things, can say idioms, saying, and other literary devices, we can put together and say that figures of speech. So, figures of speech. Several figures of speech have been used in this book just to help the author to deliver his the, I mean his intended. To over over to
NLAB Innovation Academy inatangaza nafasi za masomo ya Information Technology kwa ngazi ya Certificate na Diploma kwa wanafunzi waliomaliza kidato cha 4, kidato cha 6 na chuo NTA Level 3. Chuo kipo Kinondoni Vijana jijini Dar es Salaam. Zaidi ya kusoma, mwanafunzi anapewa nafasi ya kuanzisha mradi wa kiteknolojia pamoja na kupatiwa mentor wa kumuongoza. Pia tunamsaidia mwanafunzi kutafuta scholarships pale anapohitimu. Tupigie leo 0677 071 486 au 0744 100 231 au tembelea tovuti yetu www.nia.ac.tz.